Well, how was it?
Tight.
See how many issues we can spot just from the front of this house on the ladder. Got a hole in the shingle right there. We have missing caulking on the window. There are holes in the shingle where they put tent boards. We have no sealant next to the sidewall flashing. We have a broken window. We have a random saw cut in the middle of the Harvey Smith panel. Lifting flashing over here. Fun times.
So I've ran the sprinkler already, and I'm over here at the gas meter. I smelled some gas, and you can see it's bubbling up right there. There we go.
Here we have our water-resist barrier, our air barrier, and our draft stop. So no holes, right? Because it's supposed to stop water, stop air. Uh-oh. Not so much. Sub-panel shut off the spa in there. So look underneath, you have your hot wires. You can see that the white wire has been cut. They've cut all of that strand except for two. And then your black wire, it's hard to tell from the video, but they don't have all the strands actually in the breaker. Someone just sitting out outside the breaker.
I don't know, is this a bad idea? I don't think so. Pretty solid. Got it tied down real good. Swung around another post. Ties just can't pull out. Third story. It worked.
That's why you trim your tree away from your roof. This tree is growing into the roof. So this is pretty bad. This is actually not the worst part. Up against the shingles, but we go back here to the smaller tree. There's an edge of a branch growing underneath the shingle. Just damage the shingle. Old garage, lots of big trees back here. You can see. Good cracking. Just say this garage might need some help. Let's so tall all the way back. Alright, so out here looking at the stucco, first thing we notice is you have a lot of windows, a lot of like penetrations on the wall. We close in, there's holes everywhere, for, like previous wiring, holes everywhere. There's a lot of missing sealant around the windows. The biggest thing is we have some poor clearance to the ground, and there's no weak screen at the bottom of any of this. It's just a metal track with no holes in it. So as we look closer, you can see the discoloration on the bottom where the water is just sapped on the bottom of the stucco all the way over. The best part is you can kind of see a line where it's starting to bulge a little bit, and so I'm guessing that the substrate is probably gone. And I can't even like push on it. And you can move. You can move the stucco. So, you know that the substrate is pretty much gone on this one. They're not in great shape on this stucco.
Zone 2! Zone 2! Mayday! Mayday!
An old metal carport. It's starting to sag a little bit this way, so let's take a closer look. And it looks like instead of actually having a post, they bolted it to the wall. And it's pulled completely loose. So I like how Jimmy rigged it. I guess this is what's supporting, kind of. Should be better than that, though.
Let's see what we got in here. Oh, there's one right there.
Oh. Hello.
Checking right here for moisture. It's a damaged ceiling. Let's go upstairs and check it out. Bit of moisture back here, so got the testing moisture meter out and it's wet.
It's another one of those days.
So a stucco with no kick-up flashing, gutters too close to the stucco. You see some dark area right there. We're gonna walk inside to the exact location. You see some water damage right below the crown molding. So we're gonna check that with the moisture meter just a little bit. See if it's wet.
This video of the house with the final siding, 1955 model. We do have some damage, and I just kind of want to show you. This is the final siding. This is what this stuff covers up. Get your hand up behind there. As you can see, it's like dry wood. Go whole side of the house just moves. This is our other guys. This is the gift that keeps on giving. Up into the attic, just got into the attic. Oh, we also got burnt. video will pick it up. We got a ridge right here. Look at it split. That's gonna be a tough fix. You can kind of see underneath here where it's kind of bent.
So I'm in a 1920 house. The pipes have been beautifully renovated. What they've done is they've made a primary bedroom suite above the garage with these beautiful windows, but none of them open. They're all fixed, and they're not safety glass either. I don't see the etching for the safety glass. So we got possibly no safety glass, and there is no emergency egress out of this bedroom, you know, open the window.
Here we have some really toasted masonite. About time to change this out for some hardy.
A little wobbly, well, a lot wobbly.
And, oops, oops.
Oh, let's try there.
Oops.
Saw a little previous termite damage in this 100-year-old garage, and I took a closer look and I got some drywood frass.
I did pull a receptacle inside and I did see the aluminum wiring, but we got the panel here. A little aluminum wiring there, we got some copper wiring, we got a bunch of red lug nut. All right, you can see all the aluminum wrapped up in there and changes to copper. A little copper over here, a little aluminum over here. I think we better call out an electrician on this one.
Today I learned the proper way to run your cable line. Just take it straight through the shingle. No issues whatsoever.
The person who did this replaced some of the galvanized piping, some of the horizontal piping, but they didn't replace the verticals. And this is leaking at the vertical.
Hello, hello! Top of the morning to ya.
All right, today we're on a 1960s house, brand new roof, put on 2020. All this debris needs to be cleaned. This flue right here needs to be painted. This bare metal, this storm collar cap needs to be positioned and sealed better. Got some improper fasteners in the wrong places. Plumbing slab boots need to be sealed up. This storm collar right here should be sealed. Fasteners in the wrong areas of the flashing. Drip edge flashing pulling loose, needs to be better secured. Service mast, the drip loop is missing. And these nail heads should be sealed up better. This is the best one. There's a plumbing slab boot right here. Where's the boot? Water's getting in. This be a post tension cable.
I know. I see it too. He's mad about the storm collar right here. It's important to seal around the exterior fixtures, any openings that pass through. Because